Hello, welcome to a Q&A video. I'm going to talk in this video about what is the difference between P5JS and processing. I'm probably in a moment going to say exactly that same thing because I'm actually just after the fact recording an intro because I went on for so long, I decided to divide this particular discussion into three parts. So the first part, I'm just going to kind of talk about the sort of bigger picture of these two different environments and what programming languages they're built on and kind of how that plays a role in their features and the ways that you work with them, and I'll diagram that on the whiteboard. The second part, I'll actually show the two different environments and type some code side by side and look at the editors and see some pieces of that. And in the third part, I will make a list of pros and cons of why you might want to use one versus the other, or where one environment excels over the other environment, and as well as take some questions from a live chat about things that I missed. So that's going to be these three videos. If you find them interesting, please watch them. If you kind of don't, please don't watch them. And I'll see you maybe in the second part. Hello, welcome to a Coding Train Q&A video. In this video, I'm going to answer a question that I get a lot about the projects, the software projects that are maintained by something called the Processing Foundation. The Processing Foundation was founded in 2012. Its mission is to promote software literacy within the visual arts and visual literacy within technology-related fields. And I would say primarily also to make these fields, make this more accessible to diverse communities. And I encourage you to read more about the Processing Foundation's initiatives and projects and mission all on the Processing Foundation website. But I'm not here to talk about the Processing Foundation in this video because I have this habit of doing that all the time. The question that I get a lot, and this question comes from someone named Schiffman. Okay, so I posted this question, but it's only because people tweet and email it to me all the time. But you can actually ask your own questions here on this GitHub repository in the issues, which I'll link to in this video's description. But the question here is, what is the difference between P5JS and processing? And the last time I tried to make a video, you'll see it in this playlist, answering this question, I really went into the history of these projects and why they exist and the sort of philosophy and principles behind them and some differences in that extent. But I didn't really get to what I think was important and on a lot of people's minds, which is the technical differences. What are the underlying programming languages behind these environments? What kind of editors can I use with these environments? What kind of projects? What kind of features do they have? What's the difference between the syntax and features of both of these frameworks? And that's what I want to discuss in this particular video. Okay, so I'm going to come over here to the whiteboard for a second. Hi, I'm over here at the whiteboard now. So here's the thing. Processing and P5JS are, I would say, open source frameworks, software projects, they're kind of broad projects that involve different aspects. And so each one, let's think about each one as sort of like three in three categories. So each one of these projects is both is all three of these things in some ways. A library, they're built on top of a programming language. And then for each one of these that you might use, you need some place where you would sort of type your code and figure out how to use it, an editor. So let's think about these three categories for a second. So P5 and processing. Let's start with processing. So processing is built, is written, is a library for. So these are really kind of one thing, I guess. I'm kind of thinking of two. It's really not three. It's really two. Processing is a library for the Java programming language. Okay? The library, the things that processing is adding or building on top of or giving you features for are things like drawing, data, hardware, sound. Right? So processing, so maybe this is a good way of thinking about it. Processing, and I could sort of add more things here. So it's a library, meaning it's really ultimately what it is. One of the aspects of it is a library of code that you can call functions from. And it's built on top of the Java programming language. There is an editor for processing, which I'll say is like a desktop editor. Okay. So processing has a desktop editor that you can download and use. P5 is the language that P5 is written in and that it is a library for is JavaScript. And it has libraries also for
drawing and data and sound.
But a primary, and I could keep going with and hardware, and but I could keep going with this list, but the primary thing that I might add here, HTML, CSS, or maybe more importantly, DOM. Because it's JavaScript, and I'll get to this in a bit more, there's a big component of P5 in which involving the web. So now, where do you create projects using P5? Here's the thing. Processing, which is a project that started in 2001, right? In 2001, if you wanted to write and compile, and this is a sort of aspect of this as well, and create software sketches, you would need a code editor. And most code editors were difficult to download, install. Maybe you need to use command line if you're just using a text editor, or you have this big, giant, complex environment like Eclipse. So processing, really, the idea of processing being an editor is really fundamental to the project. You download this editor, you open it up, and you type code in it, you hit a play or a run button, you see the result of your code, you know, easy peasy, so to speak. So just as much as processing is both a library with all these functionality, a place to call all those functions in an editor is very fundamental to the project. P5, in many ways, that's a little bit less the case. Because of the world that we live in now, where you can program for the web, you know, name your favorite editor. Everybody has theirs. You can use Atom or Sublime or Brackets or CodePen, and some of these are web-based editors. Some of these are desktop editors. You could just have you could just use any text editor. You could run a server. So this is a little bit less of a fundamental piece of the project. Now, there was, and I'm going to make a separate video about this, I think, there was a P5.js desktop editor that was modeled after the processing one. Many similarities, many differences as well, but this idea of the simple thing, you download, you type your code, you press a play button, you see the result. This has now been deprecated. Hopefully a desktop editor will come back at some point in lieu of developing an entire web-based editor. So the web-based editor is currently in development. There's no public release of it yet, but certainly when it's released, I hope to have people who are working on it come and present it on this YouTube channel. Cassie Tarakasian is the lead developer of the P5.js web editor, and the work that she is doing is just phenomenal. So I'm very excited at some point that we'll be able to have a public release. This is not a new idea. There are many web-based editors. Thimble, CodePen, JS Fiddle. These are places where you just go to your web browser, you see a place where you can type in code, and then you can see the result of the code, you could save it, you could share it. This is very powerful. So while there are a lot of options for web editors that you can use, we've decided to try to make one that's kind of geared towards P5.js specifically and highly tailored to a beginner. So if you are a teacher and you've got a group of, you know, ninth graders on a Saturday afternoon for a couple hours, and you want to teach them the beginning of learning to code, what would be the easiest way to do it? Open up the browser, everybody sign up for an account, type in your code, hit play, save, share. That's kind of, and P5.js and all the libraries are configured and set up for you. That's kind of the goal of this particular web editor project. So this is the landscape between these two things. So now, I think this is worth exploring for a second. And two things I want to do is just show you these two environments and like make the same program in both of them to see, highlight the differences. And then I also want to make a list of pros and cons of why you might want to use one versus the other. But let's spend a minute here on Java and JavaScript. And I don't like to say versus, so I'll just put a little heart. Because I love these environments. By the way, people think Java is like not a thing anymore. But it's used so widely. And people don't like Java. But you know, I like all programming languages. If it's a place that you can write some code and express yourself and make something interesting, it's a good place to be. It might not be your favorite. But let's not be so mean about Java. So Java is a programming language. I think it was started in 1991, but really more formally launched probably in 1995. Everyone in the comments can correct me here if you want. And the idea of Java, the big exciting thing about Java was write once, run anywhere, I think was the acronym. Write once, run anywhere. Wora. That doesn't have like a good ring to it. But the idea is, If you were writing your code in C or C++, you would have to rewrite your code entirely if you moved from an Apple computer to a Windows computer to a Linux machine to a mobile phone to a toaster. And the idea of Java, the magic was, you didn't actually write code that's native to that computer. You wrote code in this very generic way, and then you would have something on that computer called a Java virtual machine. So as long as the Java virtual machine was part of this device, then your Java code could run on it. The Java virtual machine's essentially job is to translate your Java code, which turns into Java bytecode, to that machine's specific machine code. So this was the exciting and powerful innovation. And Java really adopts most of the same syntax as C++. And it is also a highly object-oriented language, for better or worse. It can be very, very wordy and tedious and kind of ugly in many ways, or beautiful and elegant, depending on how you look at it. But a lot of what processing did with Java is when you're working in its desktop environment, a lot of the wrapper code, the sort of extra code that you need to put at the beginning and end of every program in Java, processing kind of adds for you behind the scenes. So that makes it a little bit simpler, and some people think of it, oh, it isn't really Java. Is it? But it really is Java. However, you are allowed to, A, not have to live by this like very formal object-oriented way of thinking, although you can, of course, do objects, and you don't need all of this extra Java stuff that looks very intimidating and upsetting in a way on your like first day of learning to program, to have all this confusing stuff that you don't know what it means. So that's really what happened with processing. Now, processing was also, and this is what I spent a lot of time in my previous video, which I guess I'll try not to harp on too much here, Java made sense because it could connect to a lot of hardware and libraries for data and networking, but it also at the time, there was something called applets, which were part of early browsers. JavaScript in many ways was named to complement the fact that JavaScript might be a programming language of the browser that would complement applets, but a way of running your processing sketches in 2001 when processing was created, you could export to an applet and share it on the web. Can't do that so much anymore. So JavaScript started being developed around the same time, a little bit after. It had other names like Mocha and maybe like LiveScript, because Netscape and various companies that were developing, organizations that were developing early browsers realized you needed something that you could write code right in the browser, in your HTML, in your files, to like control the behavior and logic and things that are happening on a web page. And that's where JavaScript came from. Now, JavaScript obviously is very different now in, what year is it? 2017, than it was back then. There's been many different specifications for the language. There's an organization called ECMA. Is that what it is? Anyway, we're on version like, there's like ES6 now. You hear all these terms. I haven't adopted some of the new syntax in my video tutorials of JavaScript just yet. I'm taking a very long time to get to showing you these environments. But so it's quite different than it was back then, but it still is fundamentally the language of the browser. A key difference, however, is that while this is compiled code, you have to write your code and then run it through a process that converts it into, you know, zeros and ones so that it can be executed as an application. JavaScript doesn't work that way. JavaScript is what's known as an interpreted language. Meaning, the browser just reads your code and executes it at the same time, which allows for a lot of flexibility and exciting things like live coding or changing code on the fly or running it, typing your code in the browser and hitting run. There's all sorts of possibilities that you can explore because it's interpreted or on the fly and can change as it's running over time, as opposed to something that has to be compiled and finished. So in that sense, these are very different programming languages. The name is just there because of this thing that applets were there and JavaScript was supposed to complement that. And there's some of the syntax for while is the same. But the actual quality of the language, JavaScript has more functions. Java, everything's about objects. JavaScript is object-oriented, but functions are sort of this primary thing, and there's lots of kind of nuance to that, of course, but that's sort of the primary thing. So P5JS is just a library for JavaScript. So if you are quote unquote learning P5JS, what you're learning to program is JavaScript, and the libraries, the functions that you're calling to maybe draw or do things come from P5JS. If you are learning processing, you're learning the syntax of the Java programming language and how it works, and getting access to all these libraries from processing to draw and do that type of thing. So, and in truth, at least in my experience, people say, well, I don't want to use a framework because I really want to learn the real thing. Well, guess what? The real thing is learning how to use different frameworks. So if you learn how to use P5JS, maybe you'll learn how to use 3JS or paper.js or matter.js or fill-in-the-blank.js, different libraries and different frameworks for these languages. Okay, so that's kind of a rather long-winded summary of all of this. And what I want to do now is just show you the two different environments and how the syntax looks between them, and then make a list of pros and cons between the two.